Hi guys, this is Sofiia from magiskill.com, and today I will show you how to implement ads conversion tracking so that you can set it up on your own. And to be able to do that, we will need your online shop, your Google Tag Manager account, and also your Google Ads account. So let's dive into it. And please make sure that your Tag Manager is implemented on the web page. If you do not know how to do that, I am attaching some links for you. So let's start. Step number one is to identify our conversion. What would you like to track? In my case, I want to track a purchase. So let's make a test purchase. So here you can see my confirmation page, and you can see this part of the URL order received. Good. I can use it in the future for my trigger. So let's go to the ads account and let's create our conversion. Click tools and settings, measurement, conversions. By the way, this is the new Google Ads layout, and I find it to be pretty convenient because now you can see the conversions structured by categories. Good, so let's click new conversion action, and which is website. And here we should provide the category, which is purchase. Then conversion name, let's say order received, value. Don't use a value for this conversion action. So for now, we are implementing this conversion without a value. In the upcoming video, I will show you how to add dynamic values to this conversion, but one step at a time. Then count, we should choose every, because each purchase is valuable for us. We want to see each conversion in the report. And one would be a good option for registrations, leads, and signups. Then we have something called click-through conversion window. And this is exactly the period of time you're giving your user to convert. So a user must click your ad and make a purchase. And yes, this might take some time, especially if you're offering expensive products such as cars or equipment. Then we have engaged view conversion window. And this is exactly the amount of time you're giving the user to convert after watching your video ads. View through conversion window is by default 1 day. And this is interesting because a user may see your ad and convert later. So a user must not click your ad. And this is good to have these conversions in your reports. And it's logical that it is 1 day only, as a user is not particularly interested in clicking your ads. And the last one is attribution model. By default, it's last click. So let's say you're running multiple ads, and a user might also click multiple ads on a way to a conversion. And the attribution model lets you choose how much credit should go to a specific ad for conversion. In the case of last click, all the credit would go to the last clicked ad. So you can choose the attribution model, which would be the most suitable for your business needs. So let's click create and continue. And I choose Google Tag Manager implementation. So this is option number 3. And here we have the conversion ID. So let's copy this ID and let's go to the Tag Manager and create a new tag. And we click new, Google Ads conversion tracking. And let's paste it here. Let's copy the label as well. Let's go back and paste it here. And I will leave all those fields for now because I'm implementing my conversion without a value. But one super important thing here is the conversion linker. And it is impossible to overlook this notification. Since we're implementing those conversions not in the source code, yet via Tag Manager, we must ensure accurate tracking by creating the additional tag. So let's click create, and the system has prepared everything for us. So we must only save. Even the name is here. So let's save it. Yeah, so here we have the green tick, which is a good sign. So let's go down to the triggering section and let's create our trigger. And we made a test purchase already, so we know which trigger we can use. I will choose page view. Some page views because we want to track the confirmation page only. Here we should choose page URL And let's go and copy this part and let's paste it here. And let's provide a proper name. So let's say thank you page. You can give any name you want, but it's good to have your own naming convention. And let's save the trigger. And we should also name our tag adverts purchase. And let's save it as well. And here comes the most exciting part of the whole implementation, testing. So let's go to preview. And here you should provide a web page URL and click connect. So here is my page with a debugger and let's make a test purchase again. Amazing. So this is my confirmation page and let's see what is happening in the report. So here you can see tags fired, AdWords purchase fired one time. If you see something like that, good job. Your tracking was implemented successfully. And now the most important part of the whole process is to publish the container. So let's click submit. Here we can provide a name. So I implemented ads purchase and let's publish this version. Good. Now the question, where can I see those conversions in the ads account? So let's go to the ads account. And if you click measurement conversions, you can find your conversion here. And for now, the status is no recent conversions because it was freshly implemented. And I also have no ads running. So in your case, you would see a new status if a user clicks your ad and makes a purchase. By the way, have you seen the enhanced conversion tracking option? Maybe someone implemented it successfully. So share your experience in the comment section. I wish you happy measuring, guys. Until next time.
All right, thanks Sofiia for helping us out to install our conversions and our Google Ads account. Now you might be asking yourself, I have an e-commerce store. On the thank you page, there's actually a dynamic value that I want to transfer over to Google Ads so I know how much the user has actually spent in my online store, for example. Well, Sofiia made another video that you can check out right over there. And if this video already helped you out, give us a thumbs up as well. Now, from everybody here at Measure School, happy measuring.